Hi guys, welcome to AppSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir again with a new feature release video and exciting news. So Shopify has released Dawn 11.0.0, and in this video I'll walk you through what are the features they added. Some of the features are related to animation and some of the features are related to product page. So a lot of exciting stuff. If you want to learn, if you want to see which features they added, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. I keep creating this video to help you guys with your e-commerce journey. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen. Okay guys, we have Dawn 11.0.0 page open. As you can see, it's the latest version 11.0.0 has been released on July 26, 2023. And if I scroll down here, we have the notes, whatever features which they added. So I'm gonna walk you through one by one the features which they added in Dawn 11.0.0. So let's take a look at the first one, which is you can now add multiple announcement bar sections to your header. So previously we were not able to add more than one announcement bar, but now we can add multiple announcement bars. Now let's take a look at the backend. Now I have my development store open and I'm going to click on customize. And here we have our announcement bar. I already created feature release videos for previous versions. I'm gonna put the link in the video description. So I have feature release video for Dawn 10.0.0, Dawn 9.0.0 and Dawn 8.0.2, and I'll put the link in the video description so you guys check that out, because I'm not gonna be telling you guys the features which they release in older version. I'm just gonna be discussing the latest feature which they added in Dawn 11.0.0. Okay, so that's our announcement bar, and we can simply click on add section and add another announcement bar, and then another announcement bar, and then add another announcement bar. So we can now add multiple announcement bar in our Dawn theme, and we can also drag and drop it to as per our requirements. Cool, right? So that's the first feature which they added. Now let's move on to the second point, where they are saying that now we can add social media icons in announcement bar. So there was no option before in Dawn 10.0.0, but they added in Dawn 11.0.0. So if I go to announcement bar, and here I have social media icons option. So I just gonna check mark it, and I'll have social media icon showing up. Reason why it's not showing, because I haven't added any links in my theme settings. So let's add in my social media icons links. Let's add general links for now to see how it works. Okay, and now you can see I have icons showing up in announcement bar. I'm gonna zoom in to show you guys. Okay, let's move on to the next point, which is now we can add country region selector in our announcement bar. So let's check that out as well. So click on sections again, and I'm going to hide the extra announcement bars which I added and just leave one for you guys to show. And now let's click on announcement bar, and if I scroll down, I have the option to add a country region selector in announcement bar. Previously, we were able to add a country selector on our header, but not in announcement bar. But now we have option to enable and add country selector in announcement bar as well, right? Okay guys, in next point, we have this point where it says we can now set a different color scheme for our navigation and header. So previously we had an option to select color scheme for the complete header. Now it's they have added an additional feature to select a different color scheme for header and a different color scheme for navigation. So let's check it out. Go to customize, and now I'm going to click on header here from my customize options. And when we scroll down, you can see that we have option to choose two different color schemes. One is for our menu and one is for our header. So that's it for this point. Next, move on to the next one. So guys, let's test this new animation which they added in image with text block and image banner sections. So that's our customize. Let's test it out. So in our homepage, we have image banner. Let's test our new animation here, which they added. Now, if we scroll down to animation, here it is. So currently it's set to none. Now, as you can see, they have added zoom in on scroll. But when you try that, it's not going to work. Yes, it's not working. So if Shopify management is watching this video, please check that out. The new animation feature, which you added zoom in on scroll, it's not working for me. It's same as fixed background position. So let me show you guys. So now we have selected zoom in on scroll, and let's do the full screen. Zoom in on scroll meanings when we scroll down, it should zoom in, but it doesn't work. So I'm scrolling up and scrolling down, but the picture is in fixed position, but it's not zooming in. Shopify, it's not working. Now, if we select the background, fixed background position, it's the same behavior. So select that one and now go to full screen. And now if I scroll down and scroll up, you can see it's the same behavior, just we have on zoom in on scroll. I have tested with multiple pictures by uploading and changing the slider pictures and testing this animation behavior, but it's not working for me. Let me know in the comments below if that's working for you, because that's not working for me. Okay, next point, we added a new vertical lift hover effect option to cards and buttons. Okay, now let's go to customize and let's go to theme settings. And here we have animation, and in animation, you will need to select vertical lift. That's what they added, and select that and hit save. Okay, now click on preview and test it out. So these are the product cards, and as you can see, it has now animation effect for vertical lift. So that's the latest animation which they added, and they added in that on buttons as well. You can see that on my screen that it's giving a small vertical lift, and that's the same behavior for our product buttons, for our buy now buttons in the product. You can see when you hover over the buttons, it's giving you a small lift. So that's the latest animation which they added. Now let's move on to the next point, where it says you can now apply the outline button style to the button on image with text. So on image with text, we can now add in button style as an outline button, which we had option in slider, but we didn't have option in image with text section. So as you can see, that's the button with outline. It doesn't have any fill. It's just an outline button. Now we have that option in image with text as well. Let's add in image with text and check it out if we have the option of button to be as an outline. So here's the latest option which they added. So we can simply check mark it, and we can add an option to have button outline. So that's it for this point. Now let's move on to the next one, where it says you can now adjust the bottom padding on the subtotal section in the cart. Okay, now let's add in the cart to our product, add to cart, view cart. So by the new option which they added, we were supposed to add in padding below this subtotal or estimated total. Now if I go to customize and select cart page from online store editor, so that's my cart page, this one. So here we have option to adjust the bottom padding. So we can simply reduce and increase the bottom padding, which will add in more space below here, or reduce the space, whatever your requirement is. I tried that out, but somehow it's not adding any difference or not giving any padding to me. You guys check that out and let me know if that's working for you, because that's not working for me. I don't know what's the reason for that. Anyhow, so if I can show you guys as well. So if I select here 0 pixel and hit save and go back to my cart and hit refresh, you can see it's not making any difference to my cart page. Similarly, if I add in 100px bottom padding, hit save and go back to my cart page, it's still the same. So I'm not sure why it's not working for me. maybe my store settings is not allowing it, but let me know in the comments below if that option is working for you guys. Okay, another point, which is this one. So we introduced a new quick order list section to the product template. This allows you to optimize your product pages for bulk buying. Let's check that out. So let's go to our customize and open up the product template. Search for a product here. Click on default product. So that's our product page, and they have added a new section. So we're just gonna click on add section and search for quick list, quick order list. So that's the new section which they added. Let's test it out how it works. So that's my product. Let's drag and drop it above related products. Okay, so that's how it works. It's basically a cart within your product page. So let me show you guys. So let's save it and preview that on our theme. So select any of the product, and if you scroll down, you can see that you have this cart like quick list option showing up, where you'll just click on plus quantity icon and it will automatically add this product to your cart. So here we have two blue t-shirts. Similarly, we don't need to like click on add to cart button, and we'll simply click on plus sign to increase the quantity of this product. So guys, this one is for wholesale customers. So wholesale is a completely different channel of Shopify, where it has a completely different pricing. And this is a whole different topic and a complete topic for another video, which I'm going to discuss later. So all of these above features I have already discussed, and that's the final one, where I'll create a separate video for you guys to how to create a wholesale channel. If you want to see a video on that topic, let me know in the comments below. Until next video, have a great day.